The Gambia, land of over 1.8 million people, is home to diverse cultures, beliefs, and values born from the pre-colonial migration of the sub-Saharan nations towards the greener West. This mixture of tribes brings along differences in what is believed to be right or wrong. With every man's personality different from the other, there was a need for a framework that harmonizes these differences into the organized and peaceful society we now call the Gambia. That framework is law, order, and the institutions of justice. Sadly, a huge percentage of our population lacks the adequate knowledge of civic rights and existing justice mechanisms for effective participation in the democratic process and dispensation of justice. Hence, the need for further sensitization on our rights and how to access justice. In November 2014, a justice sensitization project called Access to Justice Civic Awareness Campaign was conceived to bridge the gap that exists between the justice institutions and the ordinary citizens. The Access to Justice Civic Awareness Campaign is a result of a generous funding from the European Union under the Access to Justice and Legal Education Project, with the hard work and expertise of a team of international experts and government institutions.
A project that has been conceived since November 2014 with the sole objective of making justice accessible to the citizenry, especially the common man, who may not have the funds to acquire for justice, but also know the right based approaches to seek for justice.
The main objective is to alert the public as to how to approach the tripartite system of justice in the Gambia, a somewhat complex system with specific disputes, and to obtain a peaceful and amicable resolution.
This campaign aims to bring awareness to the Gambian general public through the various portals of justice, not only in the formal court system, but also in the cadre courts, and particularly by use of traditional means of dispute resolution at the village level, with focus on the frontline administrators of justice, the Alkalolu, and the community mediators.
Without access to justice, and a delay to justice, is basically justice denied to people. So we thought it would be important to sensitize the communities and let them know where they can go when they're aggrieved.
This pilot project targeted three strategic locations in the Gambia, namely Brikama, Kwinela, and Sandukurao. Some of these locations usually have been on the disadvantaged side of acquiring justice due to their remoteness and relative scarcity of justice avenues. In the Gambia, most of the lawyers and justice structures are centered around the greater Banjul areas, to the disadvantage of remote regions who usually find it difficult to access them.
And the justice system is broad. It involves the police, it involves the courts, it involves different departments. So for the citizens to have access shouldn't just be limited to the citizens living in the urban areas.
There are no lawyers here. You rarely find lawyers here. Most of them are concentrated in the combos. So access to justice is like bringing them this opportunity to the provinces, so they can, if they've got any problems, legal issues, then we can assist them and give them ways forward.
So the aim is to train the elders, whom are the gateway in the society, so that certain information can be readily available to the community.
with the objective of getting civic rights information effectively disseminated to the target groups, the project made use of the expertise of local institutions such as National Council for Civic Education, NCCE, National Agency for Legal Aid, NALA, Alternative Dispute Resolution Secretariat, ADRS, and Female Lawyers Association of the Gambia, FLAG. NCCE, being a national institution that is mandated to create and sustain awareness among the Gambian citizenry on their civic and constitutional rights, duties and responsibilities for the achievement of political, economic and social stability through civic education.
Well, the National Council for Civic Education being the primary implementer, our mandate and mission are quite explicit. And simply put, it is to cultivate an environment of democratic continuity that will enable all citizens, irrespective of gender, creed, age, or political affiliation, to actively participate in the governance of our dear country, the Gambia.
It is NCCE who has been the focus of coordination of all the other implementers, entities, services, and media information to get the word out to the Gambian public as to how to use existing resources to solve their disputes.
Services of the National Agency for Legal Aid was also employed in the areas of Mobile Legal Aid Clinic, where legal advice and representation was brought to the doorstep of the residents in the project pilot locations.
Walong ko nga simfa adulta ben malaya min bente ma nga to ben watara manta mansaya. O meta na mo findu yan.
NALA in full is National Agency for Legal Aid. We provide legal assistance in form of advice. We do legal representation. We also carry out sensitization in the villages.
If you have problems of marriage, divorce, inheritance, the CADI is here to take care of all those issues. Some people also have problems of land issues, family issues, and they don't wish to go to court. We also have a representative from ADRS who is here to do the negotiation and help you negotiate without going to court. You have problems about your kids, your children, maintenance. The social welfare officer is here to take care of those situations also. We also have the lawyers from the Ministry of Justice and NALA who are here to hear all your legal problems and give advice towards it. All this we are doing free of charge and in confidence. Whatever you do or talk to us is going to be on one-on-one basis and it's going to be confidential.
Ye ketalo ye ketaro beke yadi wala so ntaman fen soto so birin nata ngin ko ben kono malomba kacala dame so mfana nganyin action legal aid la kumo moy ngela kibaro moy so nata ntata je ngeje yang attend very good so birin tata alhamdulillah yen advice la ya fonye nyanta tala dame and in Nyanta Melkela.
FLAG is a non-government institution with the objective of promoting and protecting the rights of women and children who are often viewed as the most vulnerable groups of society. The institution conducted the training of community leaders and law enforcement agencies, focusing mainly on the rights of women, children, and obligations of law enforcement agencies.
FLAG's participation in this project is to raise awareness on women's and children's rights. So our training is basically focused on legislation that deals with women and children's rights in the Gambia. So our aim is for the communities to know that these legislations are in existence and what their rights and duties are in this legislation.
A careful study of the groups that are more in need of the trainings and sensitization programs was done, and community leaders, law enforcement agencies, youth, women, imams and alcalos were identified as target groups. In the rural settings, customs and traditions outweighed the English laws in the execution of justice. Natives prefer settling disputes through cultural institutions like family heads, imams, alcalos, and chiefs. It is against this background that the project deemed it necessary to train these community leaders as paralegals in administering justice and directing the general community in ways and places of settling disputes in accordance with the common law. In each training location, the Female Lawyers Association trained 20 community leaders on the Women's Act, Children's Act, Domestic Violence and Sexual Offences Act, land rights, inheritance, structures of the courts and Sharia.
Karame alonko jorteje ye wali ye karande abeni hormone mbunya nga fahamu rosotoje na londo kafutaji. Because nga fenja makaranja nyintilinano namanalo na baluokon. So flat nteke tentu keja hii nila staffful.
Niko gender, iko human rights, ani nan walbe mumebe mamfem fahamuje. Barbiri nata nanjang, na lecturalu, nkarani mina nga fahamu sotoje ngalo nyunufanamu. Bundal mini along ko wala be lorin yim bundal ye na along ninkula te kam fana istano bunda minto yini ninkaro ke je pour bakoro na tawol be lo.
Law enforcement agencies were also trained as they are usually the first point of call when dispute arises. It is important to remind them of their role in the general process of enforcing justice. They were trained on how to settle disputes legally and the scope of their powers and limitations.
This workshop is important to us as the law enforcement unit of the Gambia, like specifically the Gambia Police Force, because as we clearly stated it out inside there, we are the first call of alarm, like when the general public needs help from the police, be it in any way, we are the first people they contact. So it's very vital for us to know what our roles are. And even if they come with their different cases, we are trained here how to tackle some of their problems that can be tackled in police station levels and those that cannot be tackled there, and the right directions to direct them for them to get justice.
A lot of cases do come to this station, but being equipped with knowing where some of these cases are supposed to be referred to is very important, because you will understand that it is not all cases that are supposed to be treated at the police station.
Development is all about capacity to function. So if you are capacitized to function, then obviously there is development. And this is what we're looking for. And any working place, development is what is key. So capacitizing us to know how to know the various offenses, to know the various issues are very paramount.
Community leaders, the police and alcalos are fundamental components in the overall justice framework. However, one of the most important components is the common man, most of whom couldn't be trained in the formal settings. For this reason, other means of outreach was designed to get the messages of access to justice to the common man. Among the outreach programs was the face-to-face meetings, drama, songs and Kanyelem performances, where the events were held in open areas in communities. FLAG, NCCE, ADRS and NALA conducted the programs to an indiscriminate audience of men, women, young people and children from all walks of life.
We could have organized trainings in the Combos or in the Greater Banjul area, but then few people will benefit. Or we go to the radio or the TV and conduct programs. Not everybody access TV or not everybody access radio, or even may not have the time when the program it's been aired to listen to that. So we think face-to-face it's important, and it's a way that young people, elderly people, the religious people, everybody gathers at the Bantaba in village meeting, and all of them will participate.
Every child is entitled to go to school. You should not keep your children home. Because by doing that, you're depriving them of their right to education.
Focus group discussions featured lectures on human rights and gave the community leaders the opportunity to discuss their problems and seek out legal solutions. Entertainment through drama and traditional songs brought along sensitizations on civic rights and responsibilities. These messages resonated among the audience as they could relate more easily to these forms of informal communication.
The drama and the scenarios that we use when you go in the community, in the shops, you hear people talking about it. That tells us that this approach, it's very good and the program was a success. As experience has it, youths usually find very little interest in training and face-to-face meetings of this nature. Therefore, a football tournament was organized to attract youth participation in not just an exciting tournament, but also an avenue of information sharing on their civic rights and responsibilities. A football tournament in each of the three regions brought along a huge turnout of boys, girls, men and women, community leaders and local authorities in the competition and exposed them to information about their civic rights. In Brikama, Fortune FC became the champion of the region. Quinala FC picked Quinala's trophy while Diabugu won the Kurao competition. A subsequent national football championship was organized in Soma, Lower River Region, bringing together the three winners of the pilot locations football tournaments, in which Fortune FC of Brikama emerged as the national champion of the Access to Justice football tournament.
It's very, very important, I mean, for the National Council for Civic Education in collaboration with the European Union to choose football
rights and responsibilities
as a sport to bring down, to mobilize people
among the audience as
so that they will be able to,
sensitize
people of their objective goal, that is to, so that people, especially the youth, should get access to justice by way they should know their legal rights and the mechanism how best you can get, you know, people, the relevant institution responsible for justice.
Kuma bata ntolele. Le joino NCC ani EU la joino kanyi sama nang meketa football de LRR. Kuma ya bata le. Because ya moja male bendi nyokang ye cool for mole ye cool fadam fancy mole many along ko mol lonu foloto but be inata ye mo jama kalamutandi wol wala mu ile nyantoti ini mol be tamala yadile mune nyanta kele la kuolti pour mo kané na kar gol o kuma ya bata nyene.
When you give out football players jerseys and you put access to justice in front of the jersey, what you are telling people is that you are using those players whenever they go out to get play football, they will be able to reach hundreds of people, and those people will be able to read the message and carry the message home.
Tona meno ni kaba abanda. Na meeting all kumanle because waro me NCC nyinge, aketa 1, 2 days, 3 days, 4 days abanda. But anytime na meeting all ke, ni dendi call me ye thala molte ma na fall ani fengol jasil ni molia je ika ni nika mona nyindi. So ko explain mole into details ko ñu le na jang asaba wo mu ñu leti ye sama nam pour mu luwani abe jene na nyadi
na daje any time nga fonna play la le ni be kata dam fo be kala dawda mol benta dawda ding e ka ñu sensitize about you know luwa mu le mu luwati ana nyanda tamanda nyadi le problem nyanda handu la nyadi le ko kundi nyanda tamanda nyadi le ka tandi ko violence tetara fo ninkel da maltema nga si gambia free from violence you know na community ye free from violence ndol van lo si ke da maltema ye free from violence wo ka dan tol fan so le ku ku ma baldi mi an ko nga soute ni NCC ni EU la ni projeto ni yemin natina
you can do it ha hey.
NCCE made use of t-shirts, billboards, murals, posters, social media, television and radio programs to consolidate the information sharing on access to justice and civic rights.
Women are normally not given the same rights or treated the same way as men are treated before the law, especially in certain situations they might experience or circumstances. When they come to the police, the way the police would handle it is completely different from the way they would handle male situations.
The government shall take all appropriate and practical measures to ensure and increase the participation of women in education, culture, conflict management and prevention in all levels of government.
The women should not be shunned away in decision making when it has to do with the household or children. They should be listened to. on what ideas they have in the upbringing of their children and the running of the household.
You have the right to be involved in politics, in anything that will bring peace and security to you. They have the right to participate. No one can tell them not to be involved in politics, not to be governors, not to be deputy governor. You have the right to be everything that a man can be.
I'll start off with the Women's Act. And the Women's Act came into force in 2010. And it is very comprehensive and a progressive piece of legislation. It is divided into 12 parts, set out the human rights of women and girls. In the Women's Act, when we talk about women, it also means the girl child. So they're covered under it. Prohibits violence and discrimination against women and girls. And it sets out the obligations of government and its organs and employers. So what this act is actually doing is also telling you what government need to do certain things in place for this act to be effective, and also what private and other public organs need to do also to make this act effective. Violence moy melni lorange lo xamne dang ko def nit mu gañ ko mu lolal mu lor ko ci dara mu metti ko dal. Okay, because mun nga ko ñaka physically gañ sa way nga wax ko dara mu metti ko mu affect ko in a way bo xamne dafa nekk violence. So dafa important pour ñu understand ka lan moy violence.
Loi kum jappa muy toroxal jigen wala xalé, loi bi amna doole pour tek la wax la ne di nga fay lu agas be ci $50,000 wala loi mun na la tej ñaari at be pare li bokut ak ñu charge la criminal offenses, loi tek la leneen lu outé ak li wala loi ta mun na wax ne nga fay ko xamne ki nga toroxal nga fay ko amount of halis compensation. Su day dafa nek nit ko xamne loi mus na ko jappa ci façon bi mu defaat ko, loi dina ko tek fine 100,000 wala loi tej ko juromi at. Su day koku mom daf ko neex rek muy door jigen diko toroxal.
There are different forms of sexual violence. It's not only rape, there are different forms of it, which I'm going to get to, which is basically any unwanted touching or an act of a sexual nature committed through force. Okay, the part of the force is what is important. Everybody has to have respect to another person's human body. We all know there are certain places you should not touch people publicly, in no circumstances.
Képp ko xamné jappé nañ ko rape moy mu daanu ci ko nit rape la loi mën na la tej diri 10 years té su féké né ki nga daanu ci ko am rape ko koku nañ né mu nék sa doomi jidlé mu nék sa doom ci situation yoy loi mën na la tej sa géré dunda. So yefi sey comme xalé bu mutut sey ku amul 18 years nga joxé ko mu sey. Sey bobu su amé sax loi mën na téggi sey bobu téggé ko bor parce que xalé bu amutut sey ku amul 18 years su loi mënuta joxé wawam ci sey. Té ñu bari dama gis xalé bu jigen bi su biré rek ñu daaxa ko ci school bi wala ñu génné ko school. Loi may na xalé bu jigen bu biir té amu jëkkal su day dafa dem school mu continue jangam be fu mëna tuté dem school. Su ko yalla mayé bopam tam loi may na ko pour mu délu janga ken amu droit muy school bi muy principal bi muy wajuram bi pour ayé ko pour mu délu buum délu school.
Kel ko xamné xalé lam wara mbokam amul fukki at ak juroom ñeta té ñu neen ñu ko tuumal suñ ko yobbo ci police bi diko laaj ni ngeen fa téwé bu len bayé xalé bi rek ak police yi. Parce que xalel amul fit comme fiti mak te xale bi su fekke ne mom mo police rek la mun na tit mu wax dara wara ñu wax lako dara lu nga xamne warta wax lolu waye su kele fam taxawé wara ko xamne dina ko ñemelo xale bi dina am fit pour muna wax lu correct parce que fofu mo neka the most important point mo neka statement bi.
In the case of a child in order to protect him or her from any chance of abuse or influence by an adult male prisoner, he or she must be detained separately from adults when bail is denied or he or she is found to have committed a grave offense such as treason, murder, robbery or gender-based violence.
If an adult is charged with a child, they will be prosecuted at the High Court. When the case is finished and they're about to sentence them, the child will now be taken to the children's court for sentencing. Do you understand?
Because as a child welfare officer, now I have learned a lot. Even I know which procedures to take when there is a rape case and when there is someone get impregnated with another man without taking care of the child. I know all that because of this training.
Police man ke kiti lati. Police buka alamano ke mola. Police yo menke asi menke no drong. Wole mu kele ke chaj ila wo chaj sit a chika a samba kiti ola yeta kiti bungoto ni ki a ni lua ye muta kiti lalabe alaman la wala ito lebe soronna bale police man rai soto purke alaman.
So the act is saying that an arrest is effected by a police officer or other persons making the arrest actually touching or confining the body of the person to be arrested unless there is a submission to custody by word of mouth or action.
Police assistance after receipt of complaint under section 22. When a police officer receives a complaint, the officer shall interview the parties and witnesses to the domestic violence, including children, in accordance with the provisions of the Children's Act. Record the complaint in detail and provide the victim with an extract of the complaint upon request in a language that they understand.
It's very important for us to know where our powers lies, okay? Because some of these acts and some of these laws of the Gambia does not only, like, we the police are not the only one to partake in them. So it's like, you have other institutions in the Gambia, though all are not known to the public, but thank God to this training now. Like, if you go back to our various stations, like, I know issues will come on this, but it will be like a gateway for us to show them where to go and where to get their right justice for their various cases.
A lot of cases do come to this station, but being equipped with knowing where some of these cases are supposed to be referred to is very important, because you will understand that it is not all cases that are supposed to be treated at the police station.
It has come to our attention that married couples will go to the police when it comes to their marriage issues and the police try to make it a police case, when it's not a police case. But I know you have community policing that you try to settle matters, not at the level of your police, but at the level of your community policing, which we encourage. But it should not get to the point that the police should intervene as if it's a criminal matter. No. And when Fatu comes, Fatu will tell you, he is my husband, but he beats me up. So it's for the police just to deal with the assault aspect of it, and not the marriage aspect of it.
Ke muta ke sindi dula killing, ita tala dula to, luako amanya na tamile tilisaba, wala mondore wate tanworo wula aninfula. Janini mondore wate tanworo wula aninfula bebanna, kufula lebeje killing, katabake ye samba kitiola, wala ye allow ye bill janini tilisaba bebanna.
Their level of understanding has completely changed, because most of them were not even aware of the certain legislations that were already in place. So we have equipped them with the knowledge and have explained to them what their roles are, reminded them of what their roles are and what their responsibilities are, and where to direct people in case they come to them with a problem that it's not for them to solve, but direct them to the right places. The project is all about access to justice. If they don't know, they cannot send people to anywhere. And the structures of the court were to tell them where to go to if they have problems. And the hierarchy of the courts, you know, we had to tell them where to go to if you have land matters, where to go to if you have this matter, like the magistrate court, the district tribunal, the high court, the court of appeal, the supreme court. They had to know the different courts that are available in this Gambia, or that are in this Gambia. So they'll be able to direct people on the necessary places to go to if they have problems. You have magistrate court, tribunal, children's court, same level. And then if you're not happy, high court. If you're not happy with the high court, court of appeal. If you're not happy with the court of appeal, supreme court. Okay? So we are talking about the jurisdiction of the court, and the magistrate court has a vast jurisdiction. It's only the capital offenses you spoke about that they don't hear, but all other cases they can hear it. All other civil matters they can hear it. Breach of contract, breach, all of those things, they can hear it. Yeah? The High Court, mom, they hear everything. First of all, they serve as an appeal to the Magistrate Court and also to the Children's Court. But they can also hear fresh matters like even some breach of contract. If it's the Magistrate Court has a limit. Above 1 million, they cannot hear it. Below 1 million, they can hear it. If the breach of contract is above 1.5 million, the Magistrate Court doesn't have jurisdiction. It has to go to the High Court.
There are some matters that goes directly to the High Court without going to this lower courts. And I think one of these issues is like a murder case and treason and economic crime. Yes, and rape. These issues goes direct to the High Court. But apart from that, all the other courts, all the other issues, they start from the lower courts, these lower courts, and then when not satisfied, you appeal to the High Court.
The Supreme Court hears all appeal cases, that is criminal, civil, everything. Court of Appeal, same thing. They hear all appeal cases. Supreme Court, High Court, same thing. It's only when it has to do with the Constitution. It's only the Supreme Court that has the power to make amendments to the Constitution. Only the Supreme Court.
Nata court bunda alfanan long. Court bunda jelle be Gambia. Miya long katata for warugula. Watu bontol nga admira koni danta alkalo wala sefo ya jelle miila ndulat.
Nunto. Kiti o kuo kurundin kabe samba sefo ya. Barisa nata jiko. Difference be temal. Dole beje orinya natala sefo ya. Bar dole beje orinya natala polisi le orinya natala court. Ha. Wotu mo sa abatam buli nyoto ngalon ne ni meme moment meme sefo la kidiedi ngalon ne meme police sota meme ngalon ne meme court.
Well, the most important part of the lecture was how to acquire land, because most people did not know. And we said the three ways of acquiring the land was through, first of all, to inheritance. As, for example, if your parents die and you inherit your land from your parents. The second one is if a gift, if somebody gifts a land to you, where a deed of gift will be prepared by a lawyer and given to you. And the third one is when you have your money and you go and want to buy the land. So these were the three main ways of getting land. Obviously, if you also apply to government and government allocates you a land, that's another way of getting it. And you know, we also described that in Gambia there are two different lands. There's a lease land and there's customary land. And the lease land is a document, it's a legal document, and the customary land is when you want to land and you want to go to the alcalo and get it. So these are the two. That's a freehold and a leasehold.
One of the most important things that I've learned from Flax training on this project is, the land rights. Because that is a very, very, very big headache and a very big issue within our community. One, the laws and the what the Constitution has said on the land, we, the local people on the ground, we don't know that.
You will see that the Women's Act has made certain provision about land rights of women. But when you come down to the community level, they wouldn't feel prepared to apply the Women's Act. They would rather go with the customary law.
Here in this community, women cannot own land. They cannot buy it, and then they cannot own it. The only thing that they can have land of is if somebody give it to them so that they can use it during the rainy season to farm on. But they cannot buy it, and then they cannot own it themselves. Because, you know, what they think is that the woman who is in that family is not permanently in that family. She will one day go to another place, you know, to get married, and that's where her permanent home is.
Luwa bi doko recognize. Wa legi
ako sign
ki nga xamne moy jaay
ako min ka waat
dafa very important
ako wos ku maya
nga signé kayit bi
ako ku aya fayto ni
because lan kuko kiko jënda du dé nek problème kenen mën na signé on your behalf su fekké am nga problème lan
ako ni kené ku problème mo sodo
melni nga né bintam nga ñew tok ci sa lan
ako yi comme min bokon té nga na nga si la kenoto
su fekké yang ko gis yang ko bay
ako du yengéjélé yembula djé
su passé 12 years fukki atak ñaar
ako na tam bi da sa ñi mu wani fulala
so démé su loi bi nga né ko dama bëgg nga gënné binta
ako ni itata loi da pour ka tanni ko i laftale ka mi té bondi wo kenoto
loi bi dula déglu
ako loi té la moy lé
nek té dafa wane mbiri lan
ako katu loi ko le ko kenna ko
mé né diiri fukki at ak ñaar
ako kata eso sanji worawula
pour nga indi sin nit code
ako pour yemo samba ko sanji tan
ni understand lan law
comme yow legui binta mu ngi jël sa lan yaangi jël lan mu ñoo tok fa yow waxulo dara yaangi nek hejna di waxa mom geena suma lan faale wala yobulo ko code ko to vie su passé bo démé ci code mi nak geneel len code bi do deglu daf la nek gis nga
nan issues problème bo xamné bobu danaka daily problème la ci police station dañ ko dé far de report fofu len dé ñun yo xamnañ né alkhali wala ñenen borom jatta yi dañ day jaay ben jatta ci ñaar ñetti nit lool problème bu reuy la spécialiste ci surtout ci combo fini façon problème yo dañ ko dé am ci station ci
yes before coming to this place I would have said like if someone comes with a land issue like taking a complaint or hearing from the individual, you know, inviting the second party, like the two parties that are arguing over a land. But now, thank God to this training, it's like I know the place that I will direct the complainant directly, not even dealing with anything to do with the matter of the land.
I am working with an alikali, together with the paramount chief within our district. And I know how important this project it is. Because as for me myself, before this, I mean, project is coming in, I know what we have been encountering. But now I've learned, I mean, a lot of things that I can even address at our level before even going out. Ketaro, ketaro, kana ketati. Meredenta.
Marriage, inheritance, and divorce. These were very important topics. Like I said in the beginning, we are 90% Muslim, and we're governed by our customary laws, which is recognized in the Constitution of the Republic. And it was important for them to know the rights, especially of women in marriage, and in divorce, and also inheritance.
Valid marriage requirements. One is it has to be a man marrying a woman, not the man and man, woman and woman. Okay? Two, consent of parties. Both parties have to consent. Dowry must be paid by the husband to the wife. There has to be witnesses from both sides. There has to be witnesses to the marriage.
Just as there were witnesses to the marriage, there must be witnesses to the divorce for it to be valid. If the man has taken those steps, either you pronounce that you divorce your wife or you write it in a letter or otherwise, there are rights that are conferred on the wife from that point. The wife will have to remain in your house for 3 months, in the house of the husband.
A woman and a man have the right to inherit in equitable shares of their parents' property according to personal law.
The principle of Sharia is, if a man dies and leaves an estate behind him, the woman must have sumun. Even if the property is not small, the woman must have sumun from there. It's a principle of Sharia.
Keta fana ngalo fana mu problem oti jane fana. Muso ita fono leko paski ita mu de musolti ite keta sono le si fama keta no le o nyanto fana soto.
Sharia ola karola na fahamu roma waraji. Bar nata na je yen karandi muso sariyango katama nya dile ke dingoni nya dile o nche manyol kan dingol ni nya dile inyanta dingoni lale natara ala lafo kan imanya na dingo force la ya futundi ngawo je kuwa kono nyon karan wonna manan siya kenot puro hakile maya dimbaya sambanyala karola o e molu temola karola o nyanto la karola o nyen kay nyin nafata dan nan tulu dam mala birin jam fo men nube suwo kono ibele be nyen karan wala fa sotol.
We centered on areas that we think that it's common within this jurisdiction. So that is what we focused on, and we created exercises, I mean group works, so that what we have taught them, we gave them exercises to do to see whether what they were taught they can pick out from those exercises. So that's what we were doing.
And we are pleased because of a number of reasons. Number one, we realize that all the subjects which were addressed during the 4 days were relevant and responded to the preoccupation of the community. The second reason why we are pleased with this training, you contributed to the delivery of the training. Not only you were heavily engaged in the working group, but also in most of the subject, you were bringing your contribution. And that helped to enrich the content.
The importance of this campaign. The campaign has a great importance to the Gambia, because the whole purpose of this campaign is to create awareness, as per the name, Access to Justice, is to create awareness to the general public to know where to go to if they have legal issues and where to go and seek redress for their legal problems. So it is a very important project that is here to create awareness to the general public and obviously the law enforcement officers.
This project has a great impact on the participants, because you know it changes their way of thinking and then the way they see the law, and then you know what they think, you know, is the right thing.
All what we learn is we're going to help us to our day-to-day operation as police officers, and we can definitely talk to the public, because we normally have community policing with the public, and we're going to sensitize them for what we learn here.
Some of these acts, I was not so much familiar with some of these acts, children's acts, women's acts, and so forth. So with this training, honestly, I have been familiar with a lot of acts.
Right, and this is a very kind gesture of them, all right, in bringing, all right, access to justice to people doorstep. Right, because most of us, or some people in the community, all right, don't have access to the books to read, because they cannot read or write. But information that carried out, information that we hear from the music, all right, and the information that individual give out, all right, that takes a long way, all right, in the life of people, all right, in connection with their access to justice.
I am more kind of defender. May ya lonko wala tan mi jan tan han million la ko ni moy londo dila ay jola ngol dila me an ko ay sembentu ya ay la nyaato walan pour su ta nyaalo
joni kala debbo gondo do fami so hoti hande hebi no jodori hebi no mari besngum so hebi tampere andi do damude do femata
londo momen nyaata londo dila be signo ya to ba fo kene ko ba for the new Lakobang, for new Mushina Sri Yane. Alhamdulillah,
they have taught us our rights and how to fight our rights. And if you have a case, where you should start and where you should go.
Yes.
The pilot project has tremendously transformed the awareness levels of the three regions on their rights and responsibilities. However, the justice framework goes beyond the limits of these three locations. There is still a large number of Gambians who have very little knowledge about the available justice system and civic rights. Hence, the need for the campaign to be expanded to other regions of the country.
On this project, we're only targeting three communities, and that's the West Coast region, Quinella, and Curau. And our wish is to cover the whole of the Gambia. This is all access to justice, creating awareness, so at least people can know where to go to in case they have legal problems and what to do. So yeah, generally, you know, we say big thank you to the EU for giving us and the Gambian public this opportunity, and hoping that, you know, more projects will come in place where, you know, we create more awareness for the people of the Gambia.
Londo be bulunka tala manjari sonkala bukarere ata ko jisuma kool kanyandi bulmano ye karandi ifam maji na sabar nyoye bi wasina ken na kairati anna lo dulale kanyandi kane fowa bukarere anna kambe anna fansu tole kanyandi.